House and Senate Republican leaders have reached an agreement in principle that would lower the corporate tax rate to 21% beginning in 2018, several people briefed on the plan said, a central component of the $1.5 trillion tax plan they hope to vote into law by next week. The agreement would also lower the top tax rate for families and individuals from 39.6% to at least 37%. A change that would deliver a major tax cut for upper-income households. We are so close right now, President Donald Trump said at the White House. So close. Many of the tax cuts would go into effect in January, and Trump said Americans would start seeing an impact on their paychecks by February. GOP leaders did not reveal all of the elements of their agreement, which would amount to a sweeping rewrite of the tax code. They were working to reconcile differences between tax bills that passed the House and Senate in recent weeks. Most of the changes added to the bill in recent weeks would expand tax benefits for companies and the wealthy. Overall, the tax rewrite would impact virtually every American household and business because of how the plan lowers tax rates while putting new curbs on tax deductions that have been in place for decades. The agreement still must be approved by House and Senate lawmakers next week, but congressional leaders believe they have the votes to pass it into law. The deal was described by people who spoke on the condition of anonymity as they were not authorized to discuss the private talks. The rush to finish the GOP tax overhaul has hit a snag as Republicans grapple with substantial differences between the House and Senate bills, and pause to consider unintended consequences of the most massive rewrite of the tax code in a generation. Lawmakers are eager to pass the bill, President. The rush to finish the GOP tax overhaul has hit a snag as Republicans grapple with substantial differences between the House and Senate bills, and pause to consider unintended consequences of the most massive rewrite of the tax code in a generation. Lawmakers are eager to pass the bill, President. It would amount to the biggest legislative achievement of Trump's presidency so far, though Republicans have had a hard time selling the plan to the public and many believe it primarily benefits corporations and the wealthy. Democrats mounted a last-ditch effort to pressure Republicans to delay votes on the bill, saying the election of Doug Jones to a Senate seat in Alabama on Tuesday night should require a pause. Republicans rebuffed these attempts, triggering fury from liberals. This is the ultimate betrayal of the middle class, Sen. Ron Wyden, D.R., said. Negotiators have spent almost 2 weeks trying to reconcile differences between separate tax bills passed by the House and Senate. Wealthy Americans, many of whom were GOP donors, demanded the lower individual tax rate, something House Republicans pushed into the final package with the 37% rate. House Republicans from districts in high-tax states, including California, New York, and New Jersey, had demanded changes that would allow Americans to deduct more state and local taxes. This demand was also met, with negotiators allowing Americans to deduct up to $10,000 in property and income taxes.